I said, shame on you. Your mother is experiencing the death of her mother, and you're being Mr. Heroin Drama Queen. Shame on the both of you, I said. That's what I said at the funeral home.
Good.
Wow.
And they were both kind of mad at me, but it was that, I think it was the anger of opening up her eyes that said, after my mother, after the services and everything else, that the next day, she did what she had to do and drove him to Florida and put him in rehab and said, you're not coming home.
Perfect. So it was you. So you were the turning point.
Right.
For them. Mm-hmm. And yeah, with the history that I heard down there, and I want to stay away from that because I didn't want to hear that.
Right.
You've been the turning point for many people. Mm-hmm. You have that ability to see within. Mm-hmm. I don't think you see or realize how much you are able to see within people and understand people on a deeper level. And it's just not because of the job, it's because of who you are, and you have that strong intuitive side. Mm-hmm. Do you realize that?
I do.
Okay. You're very insightful, and you always have a plan. There's always a plan that you're seeing. Mm-hmm. And you follow your intuition, and that intuition has guided you very well. You seem to know exactly what direction you want to go in. There was an instant, though, and this was in the last few years, that you made a choice. You weren't sure that was the right direction to go in. You kind of went against your better judgment, but you did it, and everything fell into place perfectly. Mm-hmm. Do you know what that was?
I don't.
I got to get this because I feel like I'm off somewhere, and I'm not sure where it is. I'm not sure where this is going.
I don't know.
And if it's for you, tell me. And it's not.
The only thing I can say is we bought the other bar 3 years ago.
Right.
That we didn't really want, but we did anyway.
And it worked out okay.
And it worked out okay.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, we.
That's the only thing we've.
I mean, the real estate.
We haven't done anything.
I have a bar. She said there's something for sale. I'm like, is it a cabin on the river in West Virginia? She said, no, it's a bar. I'm like, I'm looking at a cabin on the river in West Virginia. And so I ended up we took our savings and bought a bar instead of a cabin on the river in West Virginia.
Okay, so your intuition, you were going in one direction, you went in the other direction. Okay. Okay, let me see if I can get more details for you so you can click in so it's not so far-fetched for you.
No, you're actually pretty, I know.
If that's what it is.
I know a lot. I mean, I'm pretty strong, I'm pretty intuitive. Mm-hmm. I can actually read people pretty, even beyond the obvious.
Mm-hmm.
So
you can.
Mm-hmm. I see things that other people don't really see. Mm-hmm. I mean, I see the big picture. No, but everybody's like, "What are you talking about?"
You don't live in the box. You never have.
Mm-hmm.
And you are her strength. You're her strength. Do you understand that? You guys feed each other differently. You have this unconditional way about you and this caring, loving energy, and you do too. You show yours differently. You have a different energy that you give, and I pick up 10 years. What's the 10-year mark, give or take?
That's when I moved when I was a kid. I was 10 years old.
What happened 10 years ago?
10 years ago?
How long have you two been together or known each other?
Really?
I hate this question.
25 years.
But was it on and off?
No. No.
You guys have been together a couple, 25.
Yep.
Are you guys married now?
No.
We've been together.
Good for you.
92?
Yeah, 92? Something like that. We've known each other since 88.
87.
Mm-hmm. See. Something like that. She knows the numbers. I don't know the numbers. But it's been 20, 25 years.
10 years ago. 2006, 2005, 2004. Where were you guys in your life? What was that point in your life?
We were here. Everything was good.
Mm-hmm. That could have been the point that we started to become unhappy here, though. It's been a long journey to get to this point.
There's a marker for you guys. 10 years ago, it's a 10-year marker that things started changing. And you had to make different choices and decisions. You made a choice to kind of let go of something a little bit, even though you didn't completely cut ties with it, but go about it differently because you had a hard time. It was like affecting the relationship, or there was something being affected between
you. We were drinking. When we first bought the bar, we thought, you know, we were kids in candy store. We were drinking. I mean, seriously, we were out 4 or 5 nights a week, and
Oh, I was working. You were.
Well, I was working day shift.
You worked day shift. I worked night shift to keep me safe.
And then at one point, in about 10 years ago, we just.
Well, no, I think what happened was we had friends that kind of betrayed us and we kind of cut ties with pretty much our whole social group, or they cut ties with us or whatever. So
we started backing off on the drinking. So then they started getting a little irritated with us because we weren't going out five nights a week drinking with them, and then
I don't think it was that.
Yeah, and then they got mad at us for whatever reason, and then that was it. We had a whole network just completely switched.
Yep, that changed everything.
Mm-hmm. And it was about 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm. That got you back on your journey. Mm-hmm. That shifted everything. You had a choice at that point in time. There's almost like a fork in the road for the two of you. This was affecting the two of you.
Mm-hmm.
There's that fork in the road. And you guided that fork. You were the support system, but you guided that fork, and you knew that if we didn't do this, we didn't know what was going to happen. It was going to affect us in a negative way.
Mm-hmm.
And that kept you going forward.
Mm-hmm.
We're 14 years ago. Let's go with 14 years old. Anything stand out for either one of you at 14?
I had a tough life. So all of those ages from like 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
Who hurt you?
Somebody hurt me bad.
And I got tears.
Uh-huh.
And I get chills. And it's still a part of you, even though you've worked through a lot of it. But the pain and the anger came up for me. You don't carry that anger today the way that you did, but there's so much pain
mm-hmm.
that was one of the hardest things that you had to work through and deal with. Do you understand that?
Mm-hmm.
And but it just didn't stop or start at 14. There was something more around that. Do you understand that? And I don't know if this was abuse in one mm-hmm. level or another.
It was.
Okay.
And what stopped it was me. I said enough was enough.
Were you 14 when it stopped?
I was 14, 15.
Right in that.
Yeah, 14, 15.
Mm-hmm. Boy, you shut down. After that, you shut down. You protected yourself, and the anger that came up and the pain that you carried, and you just kept on moving forward. And your life changed when you're 17, 18 years old. You saw life differently than most people. Mm-hmm. It's almost like your way of looking at life was so different than everybody else's, and you saw things that other people just never understood or saw. And you saw it because of the pain that you carried, plus in the insightfulness you had, and you kind of saved your own life. Do you understand that?
Absolutely.
You had many choices to make at that point in time, and you chose to take the higher road
mm-hmm.
because you could have done things completely different because the people around you were doing things completely differently.
And I will tell you, at the age of 17, I had the opportunity to say anything and everything I wanted to say to the person who abused me because they were dying in a hospital bed. And I said, nope,
good job.
I don't need to say anything.
Good job.
I'm all good.
You let it go.
Mm-hmm.
You know that turning point in your life on what you chose to do in your life to help others?
Mm-hmm.
Stems from that.
Absolutely.
And that's that solid point for you. And that gave you a decision and a choice that you knew the strength you had, but you also saw that other people don't have the same thing that you have, and you wanted to be able to help them get through it because of the changes that it could put people through and what mm-hmm. it can do to them, to where it's suicidal.
Mm-hmm.
You've been around suicide.
A lot.
Too much.
Mm-hmm.
And still to this day, you can't. It's almost like that's harder to shake than that episode in your life.
I don't understand it. I mean,
because,
it makes me angry.
Because there's a part of you that knows, because of what you went through, there's a part of you that knows that there's a way to get through this and get on the other side
mm-hmm.
of it. And you want to take, and it's usually kids, and when I say kids, even in their 20s,
mm-hmm.
you want to shake them because you see potential and you see their lives, but they can't.
Right.
And it's heart-wrenching. That breaks your heart more than anything.
Absolutely.
And emotionally, this can be draining for you. And I feel like you took a break from doing this work for a little bit, mm-hmm. and I don't know if it was your choice or not, but it was the best thing that you could have done because you needed to step out of it and come back around to it because you took on so much of other people's stuff and their energy that it took you down a path to where you're not a depressed person, but you could feel that it was weighing you down and mm-hmm. was causing more of that depression, and you were using other things to kind of find your way out of it. Mm-hmm. And so these are things you, when you keep on coming to these turning points in your life, and when you do, you make different decisions because you see where it can take you and you're not going to make that choice. Because there's that strength within you. You were her light. Do you understand that? So I'm getting the feeling, let me see if I can get into this one. When you guys met, it was almost like a friendship, or you didn't know each other beforehand. Do you understand that? It wasn't like you guys have been friends forever and then started hooking up. You guys didn't know each other before that, and you met each other and you were friends. You kind of built a relationship from a friendship standpoint at first and really weren't even aware of the other one. You were, but you weren't. Do you understand that?
Absolutely.
And that you weren't on the same page at the same time. And you kind of grew that relationship, and then you realized one day, and this was further down the road, it wasn't instantaneous because one of you wasn't ready for a relationship. Friendship, yes. Relationship, no. Even though that was the direction. Somebody had just gotten out of a relationship. Do you understand? Which one?
Both of us.
Well, four of us were best friends. So I have.
So there's two more people that was in the
right.
picture.
Yeah, but we weren't really attached to our, the other people.
Halves.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, Mom, both of you, because it stands out that you just got out of a relationship and weren't really looking to start another relationship. You saw something. I think it was you. I can get this confused.
Okay.
You saw something in her. There was something. There was this unconditionalness that she carried, and this softness and this love, and she didn't come with conditions. Do you understand that? Everybody seems to have an agenda in life, mm-hmm. and you always see the agendas, and it's like you're so over it, and there's so expectations of people, and this and that, and people are, it's not that you're around bad people, but people wanted something. It seems like somebody always wanted something. You're so over that.
Mm-hmm.
And then you met her, and you saw what she was like, and there was a feeling of trust. You don't trust. Trust is not your biggie.
It's not your thing.
And
I trust no one.
You walk very carefully when it's around people.
Mm-hmm.
They have to prove themselves to you.
Absolutely.
Because you've been screwed over so many times, if it's emotionally or physically or even financially. Mm-hmm. But you've always come out on the other side. So you have those walls up.
Mm-hmm.
But you saw something that you actually, without you even realizing it at first, you were letting that wall down with her because you saw that she wasn't like everybody else, and there was something different about her, and she brought something into your life that made you were able to breathe, and you weren't able to breathe, and that's that tightness in your chest, that anxiety mm-hmm. you carry, and just that, like this, and always in protection mode,
uh-huh.
and she started working that wall down. You
it took
didn't
about 10 years.
Yeah, you didn't realize, but you did. But you saw something in her that she gave you a sense of security. And not financially. A sense of security emotionally and as a person. You trusted her. You trust. You trust people way more than she does. She's the one that will warn you about, yeah, no. And you'll be like, well, okay, seems like a nice guy. Nope. Do you understand that? Mm-hmm. And so you guys have taught each other.
Absolutely.
You're like, no. She's like, but I thought he was not. No. Kind of like the purse thing with Laura.
Mm-hmm.
You think way ahead like that. I think way ahead like that.
Mm.
And Laura's, you have this sense of innocence. And I love it. She's just.
And what did you say to me the other day? God, you should be like an insurance person. Because I'm walking down the street and I'm like, oh, they need to fix that. Somebody's going to trip and fall or something. She's like, why do you see this stuff? I'm like, I don't know. It's there, right there in front of me. I see it. It's like, I see stuff that nobody sees, and it's crazy, and I don't know. It's just one of those things.
So I got this confused. Remember I said that there was one of these two that the energies were attaching because there was history, and they could relate to the energy, and that's why they're not leaving? I don't think it's you. I think it's you.
I think it's me, too.
It's you.
because every time I ask them to go find an owner or I burn sage, something happens.
Mm-hmm.
Every time. And I stopped doing it. I haven't even told anybody that I've accepted my job offer here. I mean, not like told.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't told any spirits. I mean, every time. Because I honor them. I mean, I think I do. I talk to them in the kitchen. I mean, I have this guy that comes, sees me in the kitchen. I've seen them up here. On Christmas Eve, I had to come back and stop in, and I said, we have to go back and set the alarm, and I have to put the shot of whiskey out for my spirit on Christmas Eve.
Well, there is a gentleman here. I picked him up at the house.
Mm-hmm.
And I know there's women here, but there's a child. There's something about a child energy here. And I don't know what happened to this child, but I got the male energy and a child. Those are the two that I picked up just by looking at the building on the phone.
I think they're attached to me. I think it's part of me because...
Mm-hmm. Thought it was you, but as we're reading, it's you.
And I'm trying to separate myself out at this point. I'm trying to break the ties. In my head and in my heart.
So the establishment says 1902 outside. I keep on getting something about the late 1800s. So I don't know, was this built in 1902? Because I want to go back to the 1800s.
They started, according to the information,
really.
The information that we have that I found in a newspaper article many moons ago, is that Pasqual Nebro, who was the owner of this building at that point in time, he started building this building, laying the first foundation in 1897.
I got 1892 is what kept on sticking in my head. So something about 1892 forward.
Okay. So he started building it in 1897, and the completion was in 1902.
Got it. I feel like I'm disrespecting people because I keep on forgetting to use the word brothel.
Mm-hmm.
Huge whorehouse.
Well, this was originally built as a hotel for minors and then converted into a brothel in the teens.
Yeah, I got that immediately when I saw the pictures. It's a brothel.
Mm-hmm.
And let's walk around for a minute.
Mm-hmm.